mommies and daddies, welcome back to Momcom India. If you're watching me for the first time, my name is Mansi and I have an 18-month-old baby boy. When I was doing my research in terms of baby care before my baby was born, one thing was absolutely clear to me, that daily massaging the baby is so important when it comes to their overall development, whether it is mental, it is social, it is physical. And I did a lot of research in ensuring I know the right techniques, I know the right time to do it, I'm using the right oils, and you know, all the myths and facts around massage. We did a couple of videos on our channel on the techniques of how to massage a baby. Those videos got great responses, but along with responses, they got a lot of questions also from parents in terms of what should be the right time, what about the feeding, what about the bathing, and there's a whole list of questions. So in this video, I'm going to share with you the health benefits of massage, and I'm going to answer all the questions related to baby massage that I've received till date. I hope you will like it. If you do, please click on the like button. Agar aap ek Hindi viewer hain, to is topic ka Hindi version hum apne channel pe kal post kar chuke hain. So in the last 18 months, not a day has gone by where my baby has not been massaged by his father. That's an activity both of them enjoy and they look forward to on a daily basis, whether we are at home or even at vacations. Our massage oil goes with us because that's an activity that we don't want to miss. I personally have seen all the health benefits that I read about actually come true on my baby when it comes to massage. So first, let me tell you what are the benefits of massaging your babies on a daily basis and massaging your babies in the right way. Number one, it relaxes babies. Now, a lot of parents feel that why do babies need to feel relaxed? They sleep for 20 hours in a day, especially in the initial months, and they are not doing really a lot of activities. But my dear friends, if you think about it, since babies spend a lot of time just lying down, you know, it causes a lot of stress on their back, or little activity is also a lot of activity for the baby. So it's very important for the baby to be relaxed. Plus, there's just so much going on with the babies, with all the changes in their body, in their brain, the feeding, you know, so basically a lot is happening with the baby for the baby to really, really calm down, feel relaxed, soothe, and you know, hence massage is really important for the babies. That's number one, you know, benefit of massage. Number two, it helps babies sleep better. I personally have seen that when we massage our baby, which we do regularly on the afternoon time, our baby goes down for a nap for at least 2 to 3 hours. If you talk to a lot of mothers who have had the problems of their babies not sleeping well in the night, they will tell you that when they incorporated massage in their daily nighttime routine, that had a huge difference on how nicely their babies would go to bed and sleep for a couple of hours in the night, if not, you know, the whole night. Number three is it aids digestion. So it's very, very common for babies to feel acidic, feel bloated, feel gassy, and you know, that becomes one of the reasons why babies cry. During massage, when you massage on their stomach, when you do a lot of tummy exercises with them, it helps release all the gas from the baby's stomach. For a lot of babies, it helps them poop also. So that way it helps aid digestion really well. Then it also helps blood circulation throughout the body, which is so important. It helps with muscle development. For a lot of babies, it also helps with teething pain, especially when you massage the babies behind the ears and you give them a nice massage on their head. It really relaxes this whole area and really, really relaxes them from their teething pain. Also, we know that massage is just superb when it comes to improving the skin texture, all the glow in the skin, the pink skin that you see, the elasticity of the skin, all of that improves when the baby gets a good oil massage on a daily basis. The difference that you can see in the baby's skin post a massage and without a massage is absolutely clear. So that is a great way of improving baby's skin. And lastly and most importantly, massage is a great bonding time between the parent and the child. The 15 to 20 minutes that the parent and the child spends with each other, the touch that the child gets makes the child feel so secure, makes the child feel so comfortable. The interaction that the parent has with the baby really relaxes the parent also. The parent's mood also, you know, is on such high after having that nice moments with the child where both of them are looking into each other's eyes, trying to respond. The baby tries to respond to the parent. The parent tries to make funny faces or sing for the child or, you know, tell stories. Basically, every parent has their way of doing things. But it's a great, great bonding activity, and that's something that actually only parents should do. I know a lot of people invest in, you know, these traditional ladies who come down, who have the experience to come and do baby massages. But I personally feel that I've seen a great, great difference in Kabir's overall development when Saurav, my partner, spends time with him on massaging him on a daily basis. Now let's start with the most common questions that we get around massage. Number one is that when should you start baby massage? So you should start as soon as the umbilical cord falls off, which takes about 15 to 20 days. Number two, what is the best time to do a massage? Best time to do a massage is in between feeds. Your baby's tummy should neither be full nor should your baby be very hungry, otherwise the baby will not be interested in that activity. So an hour from when the baby has taken his last feed is a good time to massage the baby. Also, a good time to massage the baby is at a time of the day when it's neither hot and nor cold. That's why we choose anywhere between 11:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. because that time is when it's neither very hot and it's also not cold. My baby was born during winter, so that was the perfect time, you know, when the sun would be up and, you know, it's actually nice and cozy instead of being cold or too warm. You have to make sure that there is a 30-minute gap immediately after massage. Don't feed your baby, and immediately after a feed, don't massage your baby. The next question is, what oil should I use on my baby? So I personally have always been a big fan of coconut oil during summers, and during winters we switch to a baby oil and almond oil for the hair. So in summers we've been using cold press virgin organic coconut oil. We started with Kama and then we moved to Forest Essentials, and we were very happy with both of them. And in winters also the baby oil that we were using was from Kama, so we've been a big fan of that also. So that's my recommendation, but for some people even olive oil works best. So whatever oil that you want to use for your baby, make sure that you do a patch test on the skin. Mustard oil generally does not suit a lot of babies. Mustard oil is known to cause skin irritation, so if you're using that, mustard oil otherwise is very, very good for the body. But if you're using that on your baby's skin, make sure that you do a patch test. But my recommendation would ideally be a coconut oil, the one that we are using. I'll put the link to that in the description box below. But guys, don't massage your baby with like a parachute coconut oil. That's meant for the hair. If you start applying it on the body and expect results, you would definitely not get that. Also, I'd like to mention a tip here that apart from summers and winters, when during weather change or whenever my baby is feeling slightly under the weather, slightly, you know, getting the sneezes or the cold, what we do is we switch to a special oil. So we have a video on our channel where we've created a recipe of mustard oil, garlic and carom seeds. That oil is very, very effective, especially when the baby has some cold or some infection in the body, that really melts all the mucus and the mucus goes out in the form of the poop. So that's something that we use for a couple of days if my baby is feeling under the weather. You can definitely go and watch that video. The next question is, what should be the right oil temperature? The oil temperature should be warm. It should not be hot and it should not be the normal temperature. The next question is, can we switch on the fan while massaging the baby? I would say that don't put the baby directly under the fan while massaging. When you're massaging the baby, massage your baby in a room which is comfortable temperature. It shouldn't be cold, it shouldn't be hot. It should be something where you're not sweating, because the sweat, when that gets mixed with the oil, can have a reaction on the body. So that's something that you surely have to make sure. The next question is that after how many minutes or how many hours should I bath the baby, or is bathing even important after massaging? So definitely it is mandatory that when you apply oil, that oil is also taken off properly from the body. There is no reason for the oil to stay on the body. The oil takes 15 minutes to 30 minutes to get into the body, penetrate and do what it needs to do. After that, if it remains on the body, it will only attract dirt and it will clog the pores. Hence, it's important to remove all the oil. So 15 minutes or 30 minutes post massage is when you can take your baby and give the baby a nice lukewarm water bath, and your baby will feel so fresh. The next question is, till when should we massage our baby? You should massage your baby for as long as you can. My baby is 18 months and till date the massage routine has not broken, but I absolutely understand with some parents the babies start getting disinterested, especially when they start walking, because they are so curious and so interested in the environment. So it is going to get difficult for you, but you need to know the right tips, which I will share towards the end of the video, on how you can make your baby interested. But even if that does not work, then instead of a daily frequency, try moving to a weekly frequency. But just try that at least once a week, you're definitely massaging your baby. You know, think about it, if you also get a weekly massage, you will feel relaxed and rejuvenated. So similarly, a weekly frequency or a twice a week frequency is fine if your baby is not taking a daily massage. The next question is for newborn baby boys, that should their private parts be pulled during the massage? Now, a lot of these traditional ladies who specialize in baby massage will come to your house and will tell you that that's something that you should do, but that's something that instead of benefiting is going to harm your baby. If you talk to a doctor will say a strict no and say that there is absolutely no need to touch the baby's private parts, especially when it comes to using oil or pulling the baby's part. So please, that's a big no. Please do not encourage that. Anybody who's doing it, please try to stop it immediately. The next question is that during massage, should we put oil in the baby's ear and nose? Absolutely, that's a big no. Again, that can cause infections. If you want to know how to clean a baby's nose and ears, please comment down below and I would love to do a separate video or talk to your doctor. But don't put oil in your baby's ear and nose. The next question, how is it that you should do it? So this is very important, and for this I would urge you to go and watch the video that we've done on the scientific way of doing the massage, because it's very important to know what the right strokes should be, which part should be massaged first, and then how do you move through the entire body. So that's why I would urge you to see the practical demo, because it will be very difficult for me to just talk about it. I will link that video in the description box below and also put an iCard towards the end of the video. So please click on that and watch that video. The next question is, what if my baby has eczema? What oil should I use then? So for special cases, I urge you to only show a skin specialist. In some cases, the skin specialists do not allow you to use these common oils, and they give you some special creams or oils, and that's the only thing that you should use. Otherwise, this will damage your baby's skin further. Lastly, what if my baby is not interested? So what are the tips? Number one tip is that don't give up. Like, you bathe your baby every day, you don't give up the bathing process. You make your baby eat food every day, you don't give up the feeding process. Similarly, you have to massage your baby every day if you really want to see a massive difference in their development. So don't give up. Number two, always do massage in a closed room where it is just you and your baby. The more people there, the more distractions in your room, your baby is bound to be disengaged with the activity. Number three, try the music therapy. For a lot of babies, music really, really engages them, relaxes them. You know, when you sing along with the music playing in the background, the baby loves to see your expression. You know, the baby feels that there's a nice environment. So that's something that you can definitely try. Number four, room temperature. I'll again stress on the fact that the moment baby starts to feel warm, because as it is, the oil is going to make the baby feel warm, the baby will be disinterested. So you need to make sure that the temperature or the room is only comfortable. Last, do a massage when the baby is settled or the baby is tired. When you try to do massage as a tick mark activity, now the baby is awake, let me massage my baby, your baby will never be interested in that activity. Rather, when you do that activity when the baby's curiosity has come down, he's played, he's done his bit of activity and now wants to settle down, wants to relax, that's the perfect time when your baby will love you so much for now relaxing the baby. So that's the most important tip. So with that, we've come to the end of the video. I really apologize for all the loud noises that you were hearing in the background. That's Kabir playing outside and me working inside the room, so it's a door in between. So I hope you did like this video, you found this to be helpful. Please share it with as many parents or as many to-be parents so that they know how massage is important and how it should be done with the right way. If you did find this to be helpful, you know what you need to do: give it a massive thumbs up, comment down below, let us know how much you like us, how much you love us, any other queries that you have. Also, subscribe to our channel by clicking on the red button below and hitting the bell icon. MomCom India family has already touched 4 lakh parents and we are soon going to touch about 5 lakh parents. So join our family now.